episode 17. Take two. I still can't get it. Hi, I'm Carrie Ann, and welcome to Crash Course Computer Science. As we've discussed throughout the series, computers have come a long way from mechanical devices capable. When CPU requests are let home, the RAM can transmit just. Things in. You need like a. Like something to punch.
Oh, that would be great.
Roll into your aim. Fetch, decode, execute, fetch, decode, execute, fetch, decode, execute. Fetch, decode, execute. Fetch, decode, execute. Fetch, decode, execute, fetch, decode, execute, fetch, decode, execute, and so on. This meant our design required 3 clock cycles to execute 1 instruction. And I messed up the last line! Why? No word on whether it can run crisis at max settings, but I suspect. And whenever possible, execute instructions that require different parts of the CPU. Over the next 60 years, these business machines grew in capability. Got this. Yes. Come on, fill in. Over the next 60 years, these business. Over the next 60 years, these business. No. Brain. Let's go to the thought bubble.
Yeah, that's great. Okay, so.
Relax. Chillax time. Are nested between if and end. If. It's on another line. Because computers work with text so often, there are many functions that don't got this. Really don't got this. That cover some programming. The American mathematician Alonzo Church first presented a solution to this problem in 1939. No, that's the wrong date. The result was a high-level, easy-to-use... I'm running faster than words are coming up. And I'm, like, slowly dying. Kilby built his first ICs out of geranium, a rare and unstable material. Germanium? I said geranium, which is a flower. Just like a film can be projected to fill an entire movie screen, we can focus a photo mask onto a very small patch of silicon.
That's not just like, it's like the opposite. It's exactly not like that.
I feel like I'm in a stop sign. Interfacing with early peripherals was very low level, requiring programmers to know intimate. Sounds a bit weird. I feel like I'm playing bagpipes. Eckert and his friend, no? They probably weren't mates. These would wait for the right spot to rotate underneath them to read or write a bit of data to keep this delay as short as possible. To keep track of what a file is and what's a directory. Just give up there. Non-volatile solid-state drives, or SSD. No one calls them SSDs.
I call them SSDs.
Really?
Yeah.
Or SSDs, as the cool kids say. Or just branded. Luckily, newer versions of Windows have better protections and usually don't crash quite that often. And that's a wrap on that video.